Hi, my name is Milo. I use they, them pronouns. I'm an ESCEI student mentor, and I'll be talking with you today about your rights as a protester. Now, I am not an expert. I am not a lawyer. This video is not meant to be taken as legal advice. It is simply meant to inform you on protesters' rights and how they are protected. Here is where we have to make an important distinction. I'll be discussing your right to protest that is protected by law. This differs from forms of protest like civil disobedience or other actions that, by nature, intentionally disobey the law and are therefore not afforded those same legal protections. That being said, let's get into it. First and foremost, what is protesting and how is it protected? Protesting, really boiled down, is just publicly expressing your objection to or disapproval of something, usually an official decision or action. And your right to do that is protected under the portion of the Constitution that states that Congress is prohibited from, quote, abridging the freedom of speech or the right of the people peaceably to assemble and to petition the government for a redress of grievances. That is what protects freedom of speech and freedom of assembly as constitutional rights. It's not a total free-for-all. There are very narrow portions of speech that are actually not protected. These categories include true threats, incitement, and fighting words. You can find out more about unprotected speech here. Keep in mind that content-based restrictions on free speech should be well scrutinized. It must be found that the content itself truly requires regulation. There's also the matter of time, place, and manner restrictions. Time, place, and manner restrictions allow regulations to be placed upon when, where, and how one protests. The restrictions are required to be narrowly tailored, content neutral, serve a significant government interest, and leave alternative channels of communication available. You can read more about time, place, and manner restrictions here. Restrictions could be deemed unconstitutional if they do not meet the aforementioned requirements. In summary, the First Amendment does protect freedom of speech and freedom of assembly as constitutional rights. These rights are not entirely limitless, and restrictions can be placed upon them, but restrictions should be highly scrutinized and must be both necessary and reasonable. So, when and where can you protest? Well, your rights are the strongest on what are known as traditional public forums, which include public parks and sidewalks. You might also be able to protest in other areas traditionally available for political speech and debate, like plazas in front of government buildings. So long as you are not obstructing a property's purpose, i.e. shutting down a public park or blocking access to a government building, you have a right to protest there. As far as when you can protest, that's a tad more varied. City-specific things like noise ordinances could interfere with late-night or early-morning protests of significant volume. That being said, ordinances that are vague or leave too much room for interpretation on the part of those enforcing them could be legally challenged. Demonstrations that do shut down parks or make noise at odd hours can be allowed if you have a permit, and simply not having a permit is not enough to get a protest completely shut down. You still have your constitutional rights in the case of large impromptu protests. You can, however, be asked to move or lower your volume. In summary, your rights are the strongest in areas considered traditional public forums, during reasonable hours of the day, and marches or rallies that go on longer or pose significant disruption often need a permit. What do you do if you feel your rights have been violated? If you feel your rights have been violated, the best thing you can do is record all the information that you can. Write down things like names or badge numbers, get contact information from witnesses, take pictures. You have the right, when you are lawfully on public property, to photograph anything clearly in your field of vision. Documenting as best you can will be key. From there, you can file an official complaint with the relevant offices. This will be places such as the Internal Affairs Division or Civilian Complaint Board of a law enforcement agency. You can also seek legal action from people like civil rights attorneys, and some organizations like the ACLU have lawyers who will do pro bono work in civil rights cases. Protesting and knowing your rights as a protester are super important pieces of being civically engaged. At the same time, it can be an intimidating and complex topic. But by staying informed, you can feel confident in exercising your First Amendment rights to make your voice heard. Knowledge is a powerful thing. Do your research and stay safe out there.